And this is another crime which is happening. It looks great if it isn't in the New York Times, right? It's like Slovakia number one in per capita car production. What does that mean? It's a lot of big international big car companies are producing in Slovakia. Big five. Again, reasonable wages, the working culture is very high. People are not demanding, they are happy to work, so it's obvious choice, right, for them. So risk at Volkswagen, Volkswagen, if you buy a car called Audi, right, Audi, it's very possible it was made in Slovakia. What are the others?
Volkswagen, Audi, Skoda, Kia, Peugeot, Citroën. Now there will be Jaguar and Land Rover. Yes. Maybe I forgot some. Let's say like many different brands of cars are produced in Slovakia. But which, like, on one hand, it's good. Like it makes our economy mostly oriented in export. So we are exporting most of our products to Germany. But on the other hand, some people are thinking, what if something happens to Slovakia like it happened in Detroit? Basically, Detroit was a car manufacturer city, and a few years ago it went bankrupt. So we hope this is not going to happen to us.
Yes, that is true. Yes, we are a country of castles. It's a lot of castles and everywhere, and they are pretty. Some of them are renovated. Some of them are just ruins. You can spend months just traveling the castles. Few of them. Again, the most castles and chateaus per capita in the world, right? Famous. There is Salzburg, which is very famous. Then there is as well in Germany. Then there is this Rhine, Neuschwanstein, and those very famous ones. Yes, they are, because these was discovered under the Soviet. No one was doing the tourist agenda and come to our country, right? But we have that formations, we have the medieval castles, medieval chapels. The very large one, like how huge and magnificent is that? It's quite close to where I'm coming from. And the variety of them, little younger ones, then inspired by, some are inspired by Tudor style of castles. It's an English influence. Some are inspired by, let's say, touch of Andalusia, from Spain. Right? That was like how the rulers of the particular area were creating value and distinguishing themselves among from rural people and as well among the rulers, the other guys, because they have those wars, right? Someone is alive, someone is not. I'm better, no, I'm better, who is better, right?
Yeah, so I think it says 180 castles and 425 chateaux. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
That's quite a lot, actually, for such a small country.
The Tatra Mountains. This is how we were dressed in 19th century. Yeah. Well, it's not so far, not so long ago. This is considered a young, handsome Slovak, right? So this is obviously modern picture, kid dressed in traditional way, with very distinguished hat. That's how it is. And yes, sheep, shepherds, and the mountains. But then there is ladies, right? The beautiful Slovak bride, yes, kekon, like the bridal is huge, right? And this is obviously very hard to keep track and expensive to really do this type of wedding. But some people do, and if you do it again with full glory, then the bride can look like that, which is beautiful. And then ornament. We have distinguished ornament. Every single country around us has the ornament too, as well. Right? It's just very little nuances. It's like, yes, this is Slovak, then little nuance and different coloring slightly. Oh, this is Hungarian, this is Czech, this is Polish, this is Ukrainian, right? But that, yeah, what is this? Where is it coming from? The clothes are, they're not done, made in the saloons and the, in the city. It's like people from that Tatras living in the villages, they were doing the clothes themselves. And the beauty and the specialty of each part was where are we coming from? Inside of Slovakia, we are coming from the Zemplin, I'm from Zemplin, right? So we have a little different ornament. And so then the mothers, during the night, they were actually embroidering and making that special, right? Fashion, but the old way. You can understand that kimono is the face and the thing, and all of the variations on the katas.
Thank you very much.